may have aided in his discovery, apprehension, or lodging of charges against him. This charge is based upon a statute which provides that a person commits an offense if, with purpose to hinder his own detention, apprehension, investigation, prosecution, conviction, or punishment for an offense, suppresses by way of concealment or destruction any evidence of the crime or tampers with a document or other source of information, regardless of its admissibility in evidence, which might aid in his discovery or apprehension or in the lodging of a charge against him. For you to find the defendant guilty, the state must prove each of the essential elements of the offense beyond a reasonable doubt. Those elements are, one, that the defendant knew he could or might be charged with homicide. Two, that the defendant suppressed by way of concealment any evidence of the crime which might aid in his discovery or apprehension or in the lodging of a charge against him. And three, that the defendant acted with purpose to hinder his own detention, apprehension, investigation, prosecution, conviction, or punishment. The first element the state must prove beyond a reasonable doubt is that the defendant must have known that he could or might be charged or was liable to be charged with homicide. A person acts knowingly with respect to the nature of his conduct or the attendant circumstances if he is aware that his conduct is of that nature or that such circumstances exist or he is aware of a high probability of their existence. A person acts knowingly with respect to a result of his conduct if he is aware it is practically certain his conduct will cause a result. Knowing with knowledge or equivalent terms have the same meaning. Knowledge is a condition of the mind. It cannot be seen. It can only be determined by inference from defendant's words, conducts, or acts. A state of mind is rarely susceptible of direct proof, but must ordinarily be inferred from the facts. Therefore, it is not necessary for the state to use witnesses to testify that an accused said he had a certain state of mind when he did a particular thing. It is within your power to find such proof as been furnished beyond a reasonable doubt by inference, which may arise from the nature of his acts and conduct, and from all he said and did at a particular time and place from all surrounding circumstances established by the evidence. The second element that the state must prove beyond a reasonable doubt is that on days between and or including November 21, 2015 and November 25, 2015, the defendant suppressed by way of concealment or destruction any evidence of the crime which evidence might aid in his discovery or apprehension or in the lodging of a charge against him. The third element that the state must prove beyond a reasonable doubt, the defendant acted with the purpose of hindering his detention, apprehension, investigation, prosecution, conviction or punishment for homicide. A person acts now purposely with respect to the nature of his conduct or result thereof, if it is his conscious object to engage in conduct of that nature or to cause such a result. A person acts purposely with respect to attendant circumstances, if he is aware of the existence of such circumstances, or he believes or hopes that they exist. Someone acts purposely if he acts with design and with a purpose with a particular objective in mind, really means to do what he does. With purpose, designed, with design, or equivalent terms have the same meaning. Purpose and knowledge are conditions of the mind which cannot be seen and can only be determined by inferences from conduct, words, or acts. Again, a state of mind is rarely susceptible of direct proof and must be ordinarily inferred from the facts. Therefore, it's not necessary that the state produce a witness who says an accused said that he had a certain state of mind when he engaged in a particular act. Your power to find such proof has been furnished beyond a reasonable doubt by inference which may arise from the nature of his acts and his conduct and from all he said and did at a particular time and place and from all surrounding circumstances. If, after considering all of the evidence, you conclude that the state has proven each of these elements beyond a reasonable doubt, then you must find the defendant guilty. On the other hand, if you find the state has failed to prove any of these elements beyond a reasonable doubt, then you must find the defendant guilty. Count 7 of the indictment charges the defendant as follows: Conrad R. Sipa, between the dates of November 21, 2015 and November 25, 2015, in the Barnegat Light, believing that an official proceeding or investigation was pending or about to be instituted, knowingly did alter, destroy, conceal, or remove any article, object, record, document, or other thing of physical substance with purpose to impair its verity or availability in such proceeding or investigation. person acts purposely with respect to attendant circumstances, if he is aware of such circumstances, or if he believes or hopes that they exist, or if he means to act in a certain way or to cause a certain result. The defendant's belief in purpose or conditions of the mind, which cannot be seen and can only be determined by inferences from conduct, words, or acts. The state of mind is rarely susceptible of direct proof, but must ordinarily be inferred from the facts. Therefore, it's not necessary, members of the jury, that the state produce witnesses to testify that an accused said he had a certain state of mind when he engaged in a particular act. It is within your power to find that such proof has been furnished beyond a reasonable doubt by inference, which may arise from the nature of his acts and his conduct, and from all he said and did at a particular time and place, and from all of the surrounding circumstances. If you find that the state has proved all of the elements of this offense beyond a reasonable doubt, then you must find the defendant guilty. If you find that the state has failed to prove one or more of the elements beyond a reasonable doubt, then your verdict must be not guilty. I will now give you some information on the final part of these instructions on conducting your deliberations. There's nothing different in the way a jury is to consider the proof in a criminal case from that in which all reasonable people treat any questions depending upon evidence presented to them. You are expected to use your own good common sense, consider the evidence for only those purposes for which it's been admitted, and give it a reasonable and fair construction in the light of your knowledge of how people behave. It is the quality of the evidence, not simply the number of witnesses, that control. As I said before, any exhibit that has not been marked into evidence cannot be given to you in the jury room, even though it may have been marked for identification. That's why I went to the trouble of saying in evidence. If something's not in evidence, you're not going to get it in the jury room. Only those items marked in evidence can be given to you. Very shortly, you're going to go into the jury room to start your deliberations. I remind you that during deliberations, and in fact, any time that you are in the deliberation room, you must keep any cell phones, pagers, or other communication device turned off. In fact, we collect them. You are to apply the laws I've instructed you to the facts as you find them to be for the purpose of arriving at a fair and correct verdict. The verdict must be considered the judgment. The verdict must represent the considered judgment of each juror and be unanimous as to each charge. This means that all of you must agree if the defendant is guilty or not guilty on each charge. It is your duty as jurors to consult with one another and to deliberate with a view to reaching an agreement. If you can do so without violence to individual judgment, each of you must decide the case for yourself, but do so only after an impartial consideration of the evidence with your fellow jurors. In the course of your deliberations, do not hesitate to re-examine your own views and change your opinion if convinced it is erroneous, but do not surrender your honest conviction as to the weight or effect of evidence solely because of the opinion of your fellow jurors or for the mere purpose of returning your verdict. You are not partisans. You are judges, judges of the facts. Now, you may return on each crime charge a verdict either guilty or not guilty. Your verdict, whether it may be as to each crime charge, must be unanimous. Each of the 12 members of the deliberating jury must agree as to the verdict. All right, to assist you in recording your verdict, I prepared a verdict sheet. I'm going to go over it with you now.
Richard P. Doody Jr.
On the charge of murder, we find the defendant, please choose only one. Not guilty of murder, guilty of passion, provocation, manslaughter, guilty of murder. So you have three choices, you can only choose one. The verdict sheet then goes on to say, if you have found the defendant not guilty of murder, go to lesser includes. If you have found the defendant guilty of passion, provocation, manslaughter, or guilty of murder, go to count two. Because I'm just reading this form into the record, I'm going to continue on. The next thing on page one of the verdict sheet says lesser included. On the charge of aggravated manslaughter, we find the defendant not guilty of aggravated manslaughter, guilty of aggravated manslaughter. If you have found the defendant not guilty of aggravated manslaughter, go to reckless manslaughter. If you have found the defendant guilty of aggravated manslaughter, go to count two. On the charge of reckless manslaughter, we find the defendant not guilty of reckless manslaughter, guilty of reckless manslaughter. Proceed to count two. Count two, possession of a weapon for an unlawful purpose, the knife. How do you find as to count two, which charges that Conrad R. Sipa, owner between November 21 and November 23, 2015, Barnegat Light, did possess a certain weapon, that is a knife, with the purpose to use it unlawfully against the person or property of another? Not guilty. Then instructs you to proceed to count three. Count three, unlawful possession of a weapon. How do you find as to count three, which charges that Conrad R. Sipa, owner between November 21 and November 23, 2015, and Barnegat Light knowingly did possess a certain weapon, that is a knife, under circumstances not manifestly appropriate for such lawful uses as it may have. Not guilty. Guilty. Proceed to count four. Count four, possession of a weapon for an unlawful purpose, golf club. How do you find as to count four, which charges that Conrad R. Sipa, owner between November 21 and November 23, 2015, in Barnegat Light, did possess a certain weapon, that is a golf club, with the purpose to use it unlawfully against the person of another? Not guilty. Guilty. Proceed to count five. Count five, possession of a weapon for an unlawful purpose, lamp. How do you find as to count five, which charges that Conrad R. Sipa, owner between November 21 and November 23, 2015, Barnegat Light, to possess a certain weapon, that is a lamp, with the purpose to use it unlawfully against the person of another? Not guilty. Guilty. Proceed to count six. Count six, hindering apprehension or prosecution. How do you find as to count six, which charges that Conrad R. Sipa, owner between November 21 and November 25, 2015, Barnegat Light, with the purpose to hinder his own detention, apprehension, investigation, or prosecution, did suppress by way of concealment or destruction any evidence of the crime which might aid in his discovery or apprehension or in the lodging of a charge against him? Not guilty. Guilty. Proceed to count seven. Count seven, tampering with physical evidence. How do you find as to count seven, which charges the Conrad or Sipa owner between November 21 and November 25, 2015, of Barnegat Light, believing that an official proceeding or investigation was pending or about to be instituted, knowingly did alter, destroy, conceal, or remove any article, object, record, document, or other thing of physical substance with the purpose to impair its availability in such proceeding or investigation? Not guilty. Or guilty. And then if it says, please advise